As a student for ICAI foundation course, why do we need to understand commercial knowledge? Isn't it enough for 12th OC, 11th OC, and further we will be learning in BCom or we can say BAF, whatever subjects we are taking up for the degree program or graduation program, we are going to see all that, right? But why this subject is included in your syllabus? The very basic reason is, am I audible to everyone?
Yes.
The very basic reason is that we need to know about the business which we are going to audit. Let's say there are many categories. अभी तक आपको पता चल गया होगा. There are many categories of businesses, है ना? Right, like sole trading concern, partnership firm, joint Hindu family, joint stock company, multinational companies, global companies, yes or no?
Yes.
Why we need to know about these companies? Because every company does have a different functionality. To have different procedure for recording the transactions, to have different factors for dealing with a business, like in the education industry, right? There is a commercialization of what? Education too. We need to record transaction, right? There are NGOs. We need to understand their business perspective and we need to record their transaction. So that's why business and commercial knowledge is added into your syllabus, right? Are we clear with that? Because we should know the subject before we should get into the subject, right? We'll be beginning. Just give me 1 second. This is me. I'll be taking up one very interesting and very connecting topic. Have you heard about this?
Yes.
No. Many of you might and many of you won't. नहीं, डार्विन के बारे में नहीं, बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट के बारे में. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू लर्न बायोलॉजी, डोंट वरी अबाउट इट. आई एम अ कॉमर्स टीचर, राइट? सो बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट, लाइक वी द नॉर्मल पीपल, इंडिविजुअल्स, सोसाइटी और अदर पीपल, वी डू हैव अ एनवायरनमेंट विद अस. वी आर सराउंडेड बाय एटमॉस्फियर, बायोस्फियर, hydrosphere and lithosphere. These all spheres do surround us and affect our living condition. If there is no atmosphere, there is no air, and we will not be able to breathe. That means we will not be able to
survive.
If there is no hydrosphere, means there is no water, right? Can we survive?
No.
No, neither us nor any living creature can survive on planet Earth. Then we have lithosphere. What is that, sir? Lithosphere is composition of soil. All kind of soil. Let it be mud, let it be sand, let it be rock, let it be the agricultural field where we do agricultural activities. Right? Can we survive without lithosphere? No. And the fourth factor called biosphere. We all know all the biological things called living creatures, including us to microorganisms, to viruses, to bacteria, to everything which we can see and cannot see. These all does have an impact on planet Earth, and they are very influential in that way. So why do we learn about business environment? Like we understood our environment, every business does have an environment too. Who all are the competitor? Who all are the people who are contributing this particular factor of called environment? We will get to see. But let us know about this person's saying. He said, it is not the strongest of the species that survive, right? जो सबसे महान है, जो सबसे पावरफुल है, वो सर्वाइव नहीं करता. Nor the most intelligent one, the one who is, you can say, extra, what is called, ordinary, you can say, or you can talk about the skills which a person do have which make him special, like you can call it superpowers. Unique, of course. Every superpower which does not which is not so common is unique, right? So neither the most intelligent one, but the one most responsive to change, right? Struggle for existence, survival for the fittest, and the origin of who said this?
Charles Darwin.
I have been learning in my 12th standard when I was like at your age and was learning science. This was the person I read about, that he founded a theory called means he was the one who coined, who said that human are being originated from many many other species, and today we are humans. So it is not the most powerful company which will survive. It is not most, you can say, worthy company, most meaningful product which is selling, that will survive. No, the company which is evolving in nature, which is believing on changing paradigms, which is believing on, you can say, change matters, and he or it adopt to that particular change, that will be surviving. So our today's business environment, our businesses are not dealing, are not having primary objective to earn a large amount of profit. No, they want to survive. In this competitive environment like today, it is the 21st century, which is, let's say, the peak of industrialization, I would say, right? Normal manufacturing procedure se hum transform kar rahe hain artificial intelligence ki taraf, robotics ki taraf, quantum physics ki taraf, yes or no?
Yes.
These are not very new names, new terms which we are hearing right now in this lecture. These are all these things which we see in the movies and which we see in the inventions. You know, before some time, who were knowing that space travel is for adventure? It was for science exploration. It was for exploration of new species or the new planets, yes or no?
Yes.
But as you see, in last some month, there were few people who traveled space just for the sake of traveling, just for the sake of adventure. Yes or no? It is going to be the future. So how the business is going to transform? Yesterday I was watching just a reel on internet. It was a comparison between two countries which are belonging to same continent. In one continent, the advertisement was about the primary goods, food, shelter, clothing, education, medication. But in the next country, in the other country, the advertisement was like innovation, right? Software engineering, application based learning, yes or no? So there is a difference. Why India is a developing country still? Because we have such a good number of people living on our, you can say, own lands, and we need to fulfill their basic need first of all. Our most of the population is still working for food, shelter, clothing, medication, and education. These are what? Basic needs. So we are not indulging ourselves into where? Secondary activities, which is called the manufacturing sector, or tertiary activities, which is called service sector. If we still do kheti, how can we dream of, you can say, doing kheti on the Mars? Because reaching from Earth to Mars will need technology. Yes or no? We'll need innovation, invention. We need enlightened brains who are thinking about these all things. Yes or no? Right? So this is how the environment of a business will be affecting the whole business paradigm. Let's go ahead and explore. क्या होता है बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट? फॉरगेट व्हाट इज रिटन. आई विल से अ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट डू कंसिस्ट ऑफ इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस, या फिर यू कैन से ऑल द फैक्टर्स फोर्सेस इवेंट्स एंड सिचुएशंस व्हिच सराउंड्स अ बिजनेस एंड अफेक्ट, व्हिच सराउंड्स अ बिजनेस एंड अफेक्ट कॉल्ड व्हाट? बिजनेस एनवायरमेंट. सर, हाउ डू अ बिजनेस इज अफेक्टेड बाय एन एनवायरमेंट? आई टेल यू द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ मार्केटिंग. इवोल्यूशन अप from very beginning, it won't take much time, just 1 or 2 minutes. Earlier there was a concept of barter system. Are we knowing it?
Yes.
Goods ke badle mein goods, goods ke badle mein services, services ke badle mein goods, whatever. Right? What I have, if you need it, what you have, I needed it, so we can exchange. That was exchange, what concept in the marketing. But it was not working properly. मे बी मुझे अभी बीसीके पढ़ने की जरूरत है, बट ही नोज केमिस्ट्री. कैन ही टीच मी? नो. ही डज नॉट हैव द सेम स्किल विच आई रिक्वायर, बट आई डू हैव समथिंग विच ही रिक्वायर्स. यस और नो? सो देयर वेयर लिमिटेशंस इन द बार्टर सिस्टम. इट वॉज फेस्ड आउट लाइक एनी अदर कॉन्सेप्ट. देन आया प्रोडक्शन कॉन्सेप्ट. विच कॉन्सेप्ट? थोड़ा सा हमने टेक्नोलॉजिकल अपलिफ्टमेंट किया, अपग्रेडेशन किया, एंड द वेव ऑफ इंडस्ट्री 1800s की बात कर रहे हैं. कभी की 1800s. यूरोपियन कंट्रीज से वेव पूरे दुनिया में फैला. किसका? इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. एंड ड्यू टू दैट वी स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग विदाउट कंसल्टिंग आवर कंज्यूमर. What you want does not matter for me as an industrialist, as a company. What I can produce and economies of greater scale was considered the most priority thing. Right? Means, kam se kam investment mein zyada se zyada production karna. Right? Usko naam diya gaya kya? Production concept. Maximum amount mein. Then aaya product concept. It was failed. Kyun? If I don't like anything, how can I consume? Can I? Right. Then aaya kya? Product concept. After failure of production concept. Product. Wahan pe industrialist ne socha, if we produce the best of product, means best in quality, best in terms of everything, whatever may be the price, consumer will buy it. But again, it was a why? Every time we do not need best. Yes or no? Sometimes we just need okay type product. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then I asked selling concept. Right? Production, product ke baad which one? Selling concept. जब सेलिंग कॉन्सेप्ट आया तो हमने बाय हुक और बाय क्रूक सेल करना शुरू कर दिया. तब सेल्स का कॉन्सेप्ट आया, सेल्समैनशिप का कॉन्सेप्ट आया, डिस्काउंट का कॉन्सेप्ट आया, सेल्स प्रमोशन, एडवर्टाइजिंग, पब्लिसिटी का कॉन्सेप्ट आया. यस और नो? ये सारे काम सब पढ़ते हैं, जानते हैं, देखते हैं. लेकिन यहां पे भी हमने अपने कंज्यूमर को पूछा नहीं, व्हाट डज यू वांट टू कंज्यूम, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दिस कॉन्सेप्ट आल्सो फेल्ड. राइट? देन लेट 1980s में there was emergence of one concept called marketing concept. First time industrialists have gone to people, gone to consumer to ask what you want, right? What do you like to consume? It was a quite successful. Lekin dheere dheere humans ne due to industrialization arth ko nuksan pahunchana shuru kar diya. Global warming, hai na? Then depletion of ozone layer, ये सारे concept शुरू हो. तो फिर आया एक modern concept, modern marketing called societal marketing. Marketing with a view to protect the society. Marketing with a view to care about the society. Because everything what a business is actually owner of belongs to completely society. How? There are four factors of production: land, labor, capital, and
entrepreneur.
Land belongs to
society.
Land belongs to whom? To the people who live in the society. Labor, who is the labor? We all member of the society. Yes or no? Capital. What is capital? Okay, money. How does it come to business? Investment. How investment can happen? Due to saving. If there is no saving, there will be
no investment.
Simple hai. Yes or no? There will be no investment. And guys, if there is no investment, can the business survive?
No.
Without fund, business cannot
survive.
Again, the last one, entrepreneur. Who is also a human being? Yes or no?
Yes.
Again, a member of society. Business exists because people demand that product. If we do not demand any company's product, the company will be phased out from the market. It would be thrown up. Agree?
Yes.
So everything what a business owns belongs to the society. That's why this concept of social marketing or societal marketing came into existence, and right now we are living into era of societal marketing. To enforce that, Government of India did amend the Companies Act 1956 in the year 2013 and said something about CSR, Corporate Social
Responsibility.
What did it say? Any company which is earning a net profit of more than 10 lakh rupees must have to spend 2% of their net profit for social activities, CSR activities. Yes or no? 10 lakh se kam walo ko mana hai kya? Nahin, mana nahi hai, but compulsory? They can do if they want. Yes or no? Yes. So, ye hua aapka business environment. Right? It represents to all the external forces, factors or conditions that extend some degree of impact on business decision. Strategies and action taken by the firm. Right? A business is made up of stakeholders. Shareholder is a different concept. Who are the shareholders? Owners of the company. The one who finance it. Right? The one who bring company into existence. Who are the stakeholders, guys? The one who actually does have to deal with the business. Directly or indirectly, they got some interest into the business. Even shareholder is a stakeholder, right? So we have customer, we have creditor, debtor, we have channel intermediaries like wholesaler, dealers, retailers, mercantile agent, and everybody who is talking about the business and who is related somehow directly or indirectly. All the auxiliaries to trade like communication, warehousing, banking, insurance, transportation, exactly. They all are related to business and dependent upon the business. Yes or no? If there is something change in these environmental factors, the effect you will see where? On the business. Right? Let's say if consumer does changes its habit, right? Petrol ka price is badh raha hai. You know, that's a strategy by the government, I would say. Kyunki jo cheez mehengi hoti hai na, log uska substitute dhoondte. Yes or no? So there is substitute available on the market. Kaise?
Electric
vehicles. Which sounds now much cheaper as compared to the petrol, diesel, or you can say petroleum oil. You can say runs vehicle. Yes or no? So there is substitute available in the market. People will be shifting their demand from these fossil fuel oriented product to the electric vehicles. Yes or no? Right? there was a lockdown implemented in the March 2020. Every business does have to shut down itself because there were no people to work, yes or no? And why there was no people to work? Because government has imposed a decision. So even government in this environment, like the country's ruling pattern or system of the rule, right, will be also in this part called business environment. Let's know about another definition. Gluck and George, they said environment include factors outside the firm which can lead to opportunities. Guys, tell me, what is opportunity? Can you define it? Anybody of you? Anyone? I give you a very commercial definition to this opportunity relating to the context called business and commercial knowledge. It is nothing but positive difference between demand and supply. If demand is higher and supply is less, right? Samjho, demand is of 100 unit in a particular market and supply is only 70 unit, 30 unit. Anyone can produce and supply to that market, and that's what? If I, as an existing partner, raise my production capacity, right, and produce the extra product and tap over that 30 unsatisfied consumer, the market will be mine. And Dhirubhai Ambani quoted one thing on this. Yeah? Think big, think fast. Because ideas have no one's monopoly. It is not you who is waiting for the opportunity to capitalize. It is all your competitor who are into queue. If you did not did it, somebody else will do it and capitalize the profit. And you will keep thinking that it was my idea. No, it is never yours. When you implemented it first, that belongs to you. I give you more example on this. Jio, 2016, the whole world in India, the whole communication world means concert telecommunication companies, all these Airtel and whatever companies were there in Indian market, they were working on third generation of internet speed, 3G networks. And since 2010 only, the Jio was working to invent and work upon fourth generation. So when they came in 2016 in market, they shook up the complete market and they shook up the whole telecommunication business. And because of that, what did happen? There were mergers in the companies. Vodafone and Idea, they got merged. Why? Because they cannot keep up with the competition. So it is not Charles Darwin's word. It is not the best who survive. It is the one who is most responsive to change, who is adaptive in nature. Right? If you can change, if you can, you can say evolve, then only you can survive. Otherwise, you will not. Understood these two definitions, guys? लेकिन यहाँ पे हमने कहीं भी इंटरनल फोर्सेस की बातें नहीं की, right? That's why these two definitions fall short on defining the whole context of business environment. So what is the current definition which I said in the earlier? All those internal and external forces which surrounds a business and affect decision making of it called business environment. Any doubt on this? You should have actually. Right? The most ignited brains do have doubts. Right? And they satisfy their curiosity by clarifying those doubts. Okay? Sure, we'll talk about that. Now, this is a part of your business environment, not complete environment. Okay? It's a part picture. Right? The whole environment is divided into two categories, external and internal. So what are the parameters, what are the factors which do contribute to make internal environment of any business? It's first of all the mission, vision and objective of the company. Sir, what is mission, what is vision and how can we work upon objective? How these are affecting? Vision is the long-term picture of the company, long-term goal of the company, right? What we want to achieve, let's say after 100 years, that is shaped up by the values of the entrepreneur who is actually behind, let's say called promoters, and the promoters of the company. What was their idea to set up a business? So our vision is influenced by that. Then what is vision? It's, you can say, agar aapka vision 100 year ka plan hai, to mission decadal plan hai, 10 year ka. You cannot directly jump to become an international company, no. For becoming an international company, you should first begin with somewhere. Maybe you are a local company. So first of all, you need to become national company. Then you need to become a continental company. You can have to spread up the factors in your continent. Your business expansion will be working upon. Then you can go to become a global company. Yes or no? Multinational, transnational, global. These are three stages. Three categories of the company. International business is not that simple, right? Which we say here MNC. There is a definition of MNC, multinational, right? What is that? We will be talking about that also. But right now we are concentrating upon the mission, vision, and objective. So we defined what vision and mission. Then what is objective, sir? It's our yearly target. It's our
yearly target.
A very short term, right? A very short term factor which we want to achieve. Let's say if we have some plan in 10 years to achieve, we must divide into 10 parts. And per year I have to achieve something to reach at the goal. Yes or no? That is what called mission, vision and objective. All three of these are plans only. But the duration of plans differ. One is most affected by the values and virtues of the company. And the other one is more demanding the, you can say, capability to achieve and efficiency to work on. Team spirit, coordination, these are the factors which we should have in order to evolve. There is a separate subject in the management which is introduced called change management. Change management, which actually trains the candidate, managerial candidate, how to introduce and how to cope up with the changes which is happening where? In the business environment. Because it's completely dynamic. You never know what is going to happen. Fashion, 2 days mein change hota hai. Right? Aur zamane tak bhi chalta hai. It can change in 2 days. Right? It could last for years and years too. एक केस स्टडी छोटा सा प्रेजेंट करता हूँ. रॉयल एनफील्ड है ना, बहुत ज्यादा मार्केट में दिख रही है, बहुत ज्यादा. 90% जो यंगस्टर्स है, दे वांट अ बाइक कॉल्ड रॉयल एनफील्ड. 10 साल पहले ये सिनेरियो नहीं था. इट वॉज कंसीडर्ड एज मोस्ट आउटडेटेड एंड हैवी बाइक्स. इट वॉज नॉट अ बाइक एक्चुअली, इट वॉज अ सेपरेट ब्रांड, राइट? Then they work upon their production capability. They change their product. वो heavy bulky product को उन्होंने थोड़ा सा lightweight किया, थोड़ा सा sport look दिया, थोड़े colors change किए, texture change किया, pattern change किया. मतलब product designing उन्होंने redesign किया. And now you see in the market what is the change? It is the highest grossing bike. Yes or no? Practical है. Second example of decision, मैगी है ना. Everyone knows about मैगी, yes or no? ये एक generic branding product हो गया. Generic branding कैसे? Let's say अगर मुझे, you can say, noodles purchase करना है and I belong to somewhere, let's say I'm belonging to a rural area or somewhere, I won't say noodle, I will say मैगी. ये generic branding है. Generic branding मतलब आप जब कंफ्यूज हो जाते हो कि वो पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट एक ब्रांड है या प्रोडक्ट है, जैसे ज़ेरॉक्स, ज़ेरॉक्स इज नॉट अ प्रोडक्ट, इट्स अ ब्रांड, फोटोकॉपी इज अ प्रोडक्ट, है ना, निर्मा या सर्फ एक्सेल. मोस्ट ऑफ द रूरल एरियाज एंड मेनी ऑफ द अर्बन एरियाज फैमिलीज आर नेमिंग, यू कैन से द वॉशिंग पाउडर बाय द नेम ऑफ ईदर सर्फ और निर्मा. This is called in generic. But Maggie did one mistake in decision making. If you need to become a successful venture, a successful company, first of all, you need to analyze your consumer's perspective, analyze the whole marketing paradigm, and then you need to take successful or right decisions. There is no second chance you will be having there. If you want to reach to a high level, you need to score every time to the fullest of your capacity. You can never afford to be wrong. Because one wrong decision may ruin company's image, like did with the Maggie. Right? It was actually, they have taken decades to reach to every home like Maggie is now, or was few years back. But one wrong decision with their spices that mixed up with the lead have ruined the company's image. And 33,000 ton of the Maggie was burned as a fuel in cement industry by collecting from the market. That was a major backdrop for this thing. Yes or no? आपको image अपनी develop करनी है. आप अच्छे काम करिए, develop हो जाएगी. आपकी इमेज खराब हो चुकी है, आपको करेक्ट करना है, जल्दी पॉसिबल नहीं है ना. दैट्स व्हाई अर्लियर दे वर सेइंग योर मैगी इज सेफ नाउ. यस और नो, यू हैव सीन दैट कैंपेन? यस. यू हैव टू रीकरेक्ट योर इमेज एंड दैट विल अगेन टेक अ डिकेड टू कम. अंटिल देन एनी न्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट विल कम इन टू द मार्केट एंड टेक अप द होल बिजनेस. लेट्स से रामदेव. Not a joke. The man, he is not graduated from Harvard or not graduated from anywhere, but he is having a big venture of 35,000 crore plus. And what not he is selling? Yes or no? Actually, he did use a marketing concept like pull marketing strategy. There are two concepts, push and pull. Push is, you have a product, you heavily advertise about that product. Right? You push it into the market, people will consume. Or they may consume it, you cannot have surety. Right? But the pull is, I supply something, you consumed it, आपने खाया वो, और उसको खाने के बाद आपको बहुत ज़्यादा प्यास लगी. फिर मैंने बाहर, just एक example, फिर मैंने बाहर काउंटर लगाया पानी के लिए. मैंने जो खाने के लिए दिया, that was free. आपको प्यास बहुत ज़्यादा लग रही. Now you need to pay something. You need water badly. And the water bottle of 100 rupees per bottle I am supplying. Would you purchase it?
Yes.
Definitely you would. That's an example of pull strategy or pull marketing strategy. You need to create a demand in the market like Ramdev did. He never talked about his product earlier. He did criticize the government on black money. He then protested about what is called some corruption act, right? And later, he said that these multinational companies do sell chemicals in the market, and that is harmful to your bodies, to your health. People got their conscious, oh my God, we are consuming so much of chemical, and now we need something healthy, something which is what? Which is not affecting our health badly. And then Ramdev come with the range of his FMCG product, fast moving consumer goods product. Right? People were searching for it, and now he is in the market. So people did grab. The famous rivalry between Pepsodent and
Colgate
was broken by the Dant Kanti. Hard to understand, but that is a strong pillar in the market. Right? Are you connecting yourself?
Yes.
Are you finding it useful to you?
Yes.
So now, we were talking about mission, vision, and objective of any company. This was about these three words. Then second one is human resources. Earlier, the definition of human resources was managing people tactfully. Yes or no? Means we were using technique, we were using the coercion power, fear, to manage the people. But now they are managed by thankful. The definition is changed to managing people thankfully. 1934 was the year jab Elton Mayo and unke associates ne General Electric Company mein 7 year long ek investigation kiya, ek experiment kiya. And that experiment came into market like human relation approach. Scientific management theory, which was making people work like a robot, like a machine, is now transformed into human centric approach. Which approach? Means we now started caring our employees about. We need to take care of them. We need to train them, motivate them, guide them. We need to educate them and we need to maintain them. Understanding? Human resources are considered backbone of the industries nowadays. That's the second one. Then financial resources. There are many terms in the finances. Let's say if you have less finances, what you will do? It will happen like Jet Airways. You were best in the market. You were paying best to your people. You were loved by the consumer. But due to competition, you could not survive. You could not withstand with that competition. And that's why you are nowhere now. Are they? No, they are shut down. They have been absorbed by some other company. Right? So that is what called the third point called financial resources. Fourth one, physical resources. What is physical resources?
Machinery.
Very good. Anybody else want to say? Machinery, equipment, tools, technology, everything which we can see and have, call it asset. Jisko hum assets kehte hain. That is what called physical resources. Without which production and services cannot be provided. Production cannot happen and services cannot be catered to our consumer. If these all equipments are not there, can we do whatever we are doing right now? No. That is what physical resources. If we have abundance amount of, let's say, modern technology we are using, updated technology we are using, we can maximize our production to the level we want. But if still we are using the outdated ones, what will happen? The productivity will go down. Yes or no?
Yes.
Agar aap abhi bhi charkha use kar rahe hain cloth production ke liye, can you fulfill the need of 130 crore people of your country? Power loans for that. Huh? So, this is your physical environment. And then we talk about labor management relations. Right? These all are internal environment which I am talking about. Internal environment. Labor and management. They need to trust on each other. If the labor is not trustworthy, or let's say management is not having any trust on the labor, what will happen? Productivity will go down. Ye to result hua. Process kya hoga? Agar labor ke upar trust nahi hai, aapke managers ka, aapke management ka, what will happen is, they will not सोचो आपको पता है अथॉरिटी एंड रिस्पांसिबिलिटी प्रिंसिपल पता है. दे विल नॉट डेलीगेट द अथॉरिटी. यस और नो? राइट. अगर आप किसी पे ट्रस्ट नहीं करते, आप अथॉरिटी देंगे उसको? नहीं. इफ अथॉरिटी इज नॉट डेलीगेटेड टू द laborers or to the employees, they would actually be confused. Or they will be burdened by excess of the responsibility. So whatever structure in the management you are following, it will become a line organization. A typical military-like organization where all the decisions are taken by the top level of the management and labor without any suggestion, without any action, he need to implement it. Without any question, he need to implement it. Yes or no? That is best for the military organization, but not for social organization or commercial organization. These are gone. Jab hum scientific management pe kaam karte the, Google and you can say Apple like companies, they are saying that we don't want any formal education for recruitment. If you are best at what you are doing, you are welcomed here. Prove your scenario. Prove yourself. If you can deliver best, no matter you are 10th pass or not, you are here. Understand it? This is the time now. So, this is labor management relationship. Last point in the internal environment, actually, take a minute. This pe hum baat mein aayenge, hum yahan pe aa jayenge. So, ye aapko connect karega. Right? Management philosophy. Right? Which one? Management philosophy. The promoter, what they feel about their business. Right? What they think about their business. Take example of Ratan Tata. I would, you can say, talk about his one famous interview. You might have gone to, you can say, see that all. When he was asked that Mukesh Ambani is the richest man in the country, right, who have started his business with his father some years back, some decades back. But your business is from the centuries. Yes or no? Tatas are there. Why you are not into that list? Why you are not the top of all the richest people in the country? He replied, Mukesh Ambani is a businessman and I am an industrialist. I do take care of my people who are there associated with me and my business depends upon them. Yes or no? So, yahan pe maine kya kaha? Management philosophy. Is your dream to earn profit? Are you that much capitalizing yourself or your business? Kyunki usme na phir aapko critics jhelne padenge. Right? Because if you are focused on gaining much of the profit, you may lose something, some welfare of your people, maybe your consumer, maybe your, you can say, channel intermediaries, because every time you will be doing your cost and benefit analysis. Cost and benefit analysis in everything, which is not being done by the Tatas in nano project. Yes or no? तो एक एग्जांपल ये है लिस्ट आपका इंटरनल एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर्स. एनी क्वेश्चंस ऑन दिस? आई अगेन से यू शुड हैव वन. आई बी हैप्पी टू डिफर. देन हम बात करते हैं एक्सटर्नल एनवायरमेंट, राइट, व्हिच इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, माइक्रो एंड मैक्रो. फ्रॉम द 11th इकोनॉमिक्स यू नो व्हाट इज मींस बाय माइक्रो. इट इज individualistic approach, है ना? And what is macro? It is aggregate approach. Yes or no? तो यहाँ पे micro environment, ये सारे लोग, customers, creditors, debt dealers, channel intermediaries and society. You can include debtors and all the people who come into your mind there. Just it is for representation. Customer कैसे affect करता है एक business का decision? Change in taste, preference, like, dislike, habit, income capability, income earning capability to be more specific. Let's say if I am earning 1 lakh rupees in a month, I may be ending up purchasing some branded products for me. Yes or no? I may be living a dedicated standard of living. I may have a standard of life. I may be purchasing all those objects which is objectifying that I am belonging to a higher income group class. Yes or no? But if I am earning 10,000, I'll do all these things. I'll feed myself, I'll purchase cloth for myself, I'll purchase medicine, I'll take education, but that will be all unbranded under my budget. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? So this is how. A case study hai, chota sa example hai. Dove shampoo, known by everyone? जब शुरुआत में डव ने अपना शैम्पू लॉन्च किया तो उन्होंने छोटे छोटे सैसेस में नहीं लॉन्च किया, छोटे पाउच में उन्होंने बॉटल लॉन्च किया. इफ यू सी एंड एनालाइज द डव कॉमर्शियल, व्हाट यू सी, द हाई क्लास पीपल आर डिपिक्टेड. यस और नो, हैव यू एवर नोटिस्ड, लाइक कोलगेट का एडवर्टीजमेंट देखो, एक नॉर्मल फैमिली दिखेगा, राइट, किड्स के साथ ये वो. जब आप एक You can say, Dove का commercial देखते हो तो वहां पे जो models use करते हैं they are actually seemingly you can justify that they belong to a level. Yes or no? Their consumption and their you can say the whole surrounding which has been represented to the people, it likes कि ये एक अच्छे और income group के लिए है, upper class people के लिए. Yes or no? तो most of the people We are not consuming. क्यों? It was in bottle. जब Dove ने देखा, एक proper marketing किया कुछ सालों तक. And after that, जब लोगों को ये standardization का concept समझ में आया कि this is for the wealthy people, right? The person who is earning 5,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees in a month and whole family is dependent upon that particular person cannot consume this. Tab unhone 1.5 rupees ka, 1.5 rupees ka sachets launch kiya, pouch launch kiya. I cannot spend, if I am earning 10,000 in a month, I cannot spend 500 rupees for a bottle of shampoo, but I can surely invest 1.5 rupees. Yes or no?
Yes.
So now they have expanded their market. Right? Nike, Apple, right? All these branded, jinka ek hype created hai pure market mein, what if they are lowering their prices? Consumption increases. Why? Because people admire to consume these all brands. Exactly. Yes or no?
Yes.
Bol ho raha hai kya? Huh? और हो रहा है तो फिर दिस इज अ रॉन्ग क्लास. चलो कस्टमर समझे पर नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट क्रेडिटर्स. हु आर द क्रेडिटर्स? द वन हु गिव मनी टू अस. नहीं, ओके, वी हैव नॉट पेड, वी हैव टू पे. तो वही हो गया ना, द वन हू फाइनेंसेस, है ना, द वन हू फाइनेंसेस. तो क्या आएगा क्रेडिटर्स में, लाइक ऑल द बैंकिंग कंपनीज, ऑल द एनबीएफसीज, नॉन बैंकिंग फाइनेंशियल कंपनीज, यस और नो, इंडिविजुअल पीपल, राइट, पब्लिक डिपॉजिट के फॉर्म में हम लेते हैं ना, दे ऑल आर व्हाट, क्रेडिटर्स टू द कंपनी. नाउ दीज पीपल डू हैव अ सेपरेट एजेंडा, व्हाई एनीबॉडी वुड गिव money to you, why anybody would give his money to you, better than the banks, yes or no, interest better than banks or any other financial companies offering them. Hum FDs kyun nahi karte, hum kyun shares mein invest karte hain, reason, the returns are more as compared to normal fixed deposit, right? So we tends to earn more. अगर मुझे income कम मिला, returns of my investment have gone down, then I will be frustrated. And I will take back my investment. Yes or no?
Yes.
Will anybody else will finance you? नहीं. अगर आप returns अच्छे नहीं दे सकते, तो nobody is going to finance you. That means you need to remain in profit for them. Yes or no? एंड प्रॉफिट भी कैसा, एक सब्सटेंशियल अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट, एलन मस्क ने कुछ सालों पहले जस्ट एक प्रैंक किया था. It was 1st April and he said that my company is Tesla. My company is struggling with the finances and it is into huge losses. If you thought what did happen? Unka ye ek responsible person who is the voice of his business. Right? Uska ye statement ki wajah se share market mein uska prices kam ho gaya. And due to that, the whole lobby of investors, lobby of creditors, right, was angry upon that man because it was their losses. Yes or no? अब हम बात करते हैं dealers. Who are the dealers? आप यहाँ पे दो चीजों को ले सकते हैं. कौन? एक आपका wholesaler, दूसरा आपका
retailer.
हाँ, retailer भी कह सकते हो. Mercantile agents भी कह सकते हो, right? Nationwide जो agents होते हैं. तो wholesalers and the retailers, why they sell your product? If you are a trader, they are a trader, na? The one who manufactures nothing, but he purchases and sells, is called trader. If you are a trader, why you are in the market? Profit. And the profit is given in the form of commissions. And if I'm not getting good commission from your product, I may be selling your competitor's one. Yes or no? एक example देता हूँ. क्या? Vimal's. पता है ना Vimal's क्या है? Vimal गुटका नहीं. Vimal's, the famous Reliance brand for fabric cloth. Right? 70s में धीरूभाई अंबानी ने राजकोट में एक factory लगाया और उसमें cloth production करना शुरू किया. It was his first business. Right? कॉटन से पहले वो यू कैन से या मुंबई में कॉटन का रॉ कॉटन का सप्लाई करते थे एंड लेटर ही व्हेन ही गॉट सम सब्सटेंशियल अमाउंट ऑफ अर्निंग ही इनिशिएटेड अ फैक्ट्री. तो उन्होंने फैब्रिक प्राइम क्वालिटी का फैब्रिक प्रोड्यूस किया. लेकिन उस टाइम पे ना लॉबिंग चलती थी, लॉबी की. तो होलसेलर्स ने उनके प्रोडक्ट को एक्सेप्ट करने से, सेल करने से मना कर दिया क्योंकि उनके जो एग्जिस्टिंग कॉम्पिटिटर थे, एग्जिस्टिंग जो क्लाइंट थे होलसेलर्स के, वो उनको अच्छा पे कर रहे थे. एग्जाम्पल मिला, रिफ्यूज किया. देन व्हाट डिड, व्हाट वाज द मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ धीरूभाई अंबानी? व्हाट डिड ही डू? ही एलिमिनेटेड द होलसेलर्स एंड ही डायरेक्टली रीच टू द रिटेलर्स, नॉट कंज्यूमर. दैट वुड बी डायरेक्ट मार्केटिंग, राइट? ही विल डायरेक्टली रीच टू द रिटेलर. Dumped off his product in the, you can say, shops of all the retailers and said, "Jab sell hoga tab paisa." It was introduction of this product into the market. And later on, the product got so successful ki logon ne sirf only Vimal's consume karna shuru kiya. To company ne 10 saalon baad apna naam Vimal se change karke only Vimal's kiya. Understanding? Marketing strategy and the example of dealers. Then आता है channel intermediaries. अब इसमें कौन लोग आते हैं? इसमें आते हैं आपका पूरा का पूरा chain आ जाता है. The one who produces the product, they are called producers. He give to agent. Agents provide product to the wholesalers, they sell to the retailers, and finally product reaches to the customers or consumers, right? Now, this is the longest channel, you can say, of distribution. The shortest is producer to directly consumer, which is called direct marketing, right? It may be in the form of, let's say, offline sale, like Bata is doing by establishing its own showcases or showrooms, right? Or like HP is doing, right? By having their own what is called a website for selling. Right now, all the businesses does have their website and they sell, right? Because of the e-commerce evolution. So, यहाँ पे ये जितने भी लोग हैं, they are working for their and they support producer to produce the product. If producer is not helping them to be rich or to maximize their profit or wealth, they would leave this particular producer and join somebody else. तो पूरा का पूरा SCM supply chain model will get disturbed. That's why a producer or a company need to think about their channel intermediary. This particular whole you can say setup is known as channel of distribution. And now last society. If you do nothing for the society, if you do not do much or do great with the society, अब ये टाइम नहीं है कि आप जस्ट सेल करो और बोल जाओ. अर्लियर इट वॉज वर्किंग कि आपने कंज्यूमर को प्रोडक्ट सेल किया एंड यू फॉरगॉट, नो आफ्टर सेल सर्विस, नो वारंटी, नो गारंटी, नथिंग. अब ऐसा नहीं है, कंपटीशन बहुत ज्यादा टफ है, कट थ्रोट, गला काट कंपटीशन. यस और नो? इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू सेटिस्फाई योर कंज्यूमर्स डिमांड, समबडी एल्स विल कम एंड डू दैट. And you will lose your market share. Understanding? So, society. What type of expectation does it have? Good products? Consumers ke right padhe hain aapke? Aapne padhe hain na? Rights of consumers. Hai na? Wo sare fulfill hone chahiye. At the same time, there should be, something should be done from the company point of view to the, you can say, society. Corruption should not be done. Environmental protection और green consumerism का concept, green production का concept, green marketing का concept should be implemented so that the health of the people who live, who stay in the society will not be getting harmful. ये है society. समझ में आया ये अच्छे से? क्योंकि doubt नहीं macro environment which is called aggregate factors or aggregate environment. Kya hota hai yahan pe? Let's see. First one, economic. Economic environment of the country and whole world. Dono bhi. If there is a problem in, let's say, any international market, in any industry, right? The same will be affected to your economy. Samjho, there is a recession in the world. How can you be unaffected? Because you are a player to global market. Right? Before 1991, wo fark nahi padta tha hame. 1991 se pehle, India was a closed economy. जब हम इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड्स को प्रमोट नहीं करते थे, वेलकम नहीं करते थे, but now the scenario has changed. That what did happen? If let's say there is a fluctuation in the petroleum price or gold price in international market, the same reflects to our country. Yes or no? So economic environment. क्या क्या होता है? आपने economics में पढ़ा रहेगा. Economic conditions. Recession. उसके पहले depression. है ना? फिर recovery. फिर inflation. Boom. पीक पीरियड जिसको कहते हैं. सर ये कैसे होता है? हाउ डज इट एक्चुअली फंक्शन? सिंपल सा एग्जांपल देता हूं, लाइक अ लेमैन. आई टेक दिस बिकॉज इंडिया में मनी कौन प्रोड्यूस करता है? प्रिंट करता है. आरबीआई ने प्रिंट किया मनी और उसको मार्केट में कैसे लेके आएगा? कॉमर्शियल बैंक से. It will lend to commercial banks. Yes or no? Commercial bank will lend to industries. Industries factor payment ke form mein. Factor payment matlab kya? Land ke liye rent, labor ke liye salaries, wages, incentives, bonuses, hai na? Phir capital ke liye interest, profit, aur entrepreneur ke liye प्रॉफिट, राइट? इस फॉर्म में पैसा कहां जाता है? सोसाइटी में जाता है. गया सोसाइटी में, आपके पास पैसे आए तो आप क्या करते हो? अपनी नीड सेटिस्फाई करते हैं. सो व्हेन द सैलरी गेट्स क्रेडिट टू अ एम्प्लॉइज अकाउंट, ही विल गो टू बाई द थिंग्स. कहां से खरीदेगा? इंडस्ट्री से प्रोडक्ट खरीदेगा. यस और नो? तो वापस पैसा सोसाइटी से निकल के कहां पे गया? इंडस्ट्री में, राइट? अब इंडस्ट्री को पैसा मिला तो उन्होंने यहाँ पे लोन लिया था कमर्शियल बैंक से, दे विल रीपे इट. यस और नो? एंड आरबीआई से इन्होंने लोन लिया था, दे विल रिपे. तो ये एक साइकिल बना, ये एक सर्कल बना, यस और नो. अगर इसको हम क्या कहते हैं, सर्कुलेशन ऑफ मनी, राइट, क्या कहते हैं,
सर्कुलेशन ऑफ मनी.
अगर ये ज्यादा है, राइट, इफ इट इज हाई, इट इज कॉल्ड इन्फ्लेशन, राइट. अगर ये कम है तो उसको हम रिसेशन कहते हैं. बहुत ज्यादा कम है तो डिप्रेशन. रिकवर हो रहा है मतलब मॉडरेटली मॉडरेटली धीरे धीरे रिकवर हो रहा है, तो दैट इज अ रिकवरी फेज. व्हाट इज फर्दर डेफिनेशन ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन? इट कुड बी सेड दैट द मनी वैल्यू, मनी का जो वैल्यू है दैट इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज इंक्रीजिंग, दैट्स इन्फ्लेशन. ऐसे कंडीशन में लोगों के पास बहुत ज्यादा पैसा, राइट, उससे डिमांड बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ती है. डिमांड बढ़ती है तो क्या बढ़ेगा, प्राइसेस भी बढ़ेगा, बिकॉज सप्लाई इज लिमिटेड. यस और नो? सप्लाई इज लिमिटेड तो क्या क्या ट्रिगर करेगा, प्राइसेस बढ़ेगा, विच इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन. अब इकोनॉमिक्स के बारे में बात करें तो इन्फ्लेशन के भी बहुत सारे कैटेगरीज होते हैं, बट राइट नाउ वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट. सो डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द इकोनॉमिक एनवायरनमेंट इज अफेक्टिंग अ बिजनेस?
यस.
Then socio-cultural environment, social and cultural environment mixed up together called socio-cultural environment. How does it affect? कोई भी फेस्टिवल होता है ना, businessman do prepare himself for that. Not only your local retailer, but also the giants like Amazon, Flipkart and all the companies, they do prepare themselves for that. Yes or no? Sale, offer, big billion days, ye wo duniya bhar ki cheeze. Why? So that, dekho, India mein na, ya pure world mein, har jagah pe, festivals jo hote hai na, ye festivities, ye trigger karte hai consumption ko. Hai na? To related, ab jaise India mein, bahut sare festival hai, अपने आप को उसी के हिसाब से उन्होंने कंफिगर किया, राइट. यूएस में अलग फेस्टिवल्स हैं, राइट, उनके हिसाब से उन्होंने अपने आप को कंफिगर किया. गल्फ कंट्रीज में जो फेस्टिवल्स हैं उनके हिसाब से वहां पे कंफिगर. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? तो जहां पे अगर आप देखो, एक प्रैक्टिकल केस स्टडीज बताओ, मैकडॉनल्ड्स बताओ. That was a big question. When it entered into India, like in other countries, they have pork and beef product. Yes or no? But India mein danga hai. Yes or no? Of course. Right? We are in the classroom. We are not political now. Right? We are marketers, or the business entrepreneurs, or the analysts, which is, we are analyzing the information. तो ग्लोबली सक्सेसफुल ब्रांड मैकडी जब इंडिया में आया और सेम प्रोडक्ट उन्होंने लॉन्च किया, वॉज इट डिमांडेड? नॉट एट ऑल. लोगों का रिस्पॉन्स देख के मैकडॉनल्ड्स खुद डर गया. ऑफकोर्स कोई भी डर जाएगा ना. एक ऐसा प्रोडक्ट जो दुनिया भर में सक्सेसफुल है, इंडिया में फ्लॉप हो रहा है. तो उन्होंने इंडियन मार्केटिंग स्पेशलिस्ट को हायर किया, एक टीम हायर किया, रिसर्चर्स को हायर किया, एंड दे कंडक्टेड अ मार्केट रिसर्च फॉर होम मैकडी, एंड दे सजेस्टेड आफ्टर एनालाइजिंग द ट्रेंड एंड एवरीथिंग, दे सजेस्टेड टू रिप्लेस द मेन्यू विद द चिकन एंड वेजिटेरियन प्रोडक्ट. है ना? यू सी द रिजल्ट टुडे मैकडी का. Yes or no? दूसरा एग्जाम्पल, जापान एंड यूएस राइवलरी है. किसने कहा नहीं
है?
आपके कंट्री के ऊपर कोई एटम बम, बम छोड़ो एटम बम फेंकेगा, दो शहर तबाह कर देगा, आप उसके साथ बर्गर खाएंगे? इंडिया में होता तो खाते. बट It is not applicable to Japanese-like mentality of people. They are very patriotic. तो यूएस के जो यूएस में ना एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोडक्ट्स बहुत अच्छे होते हैं, राइट? तो ऑरेंजेस, इट इज फेमस फॉर द ऑरेंजेस, राइट? एंड जापान की कंडीशन तो पता है, एक माउंटेन है चारों तरफ से, ओशन से घिरा हुआ है, एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड उनके पास बहुत कम है, राइट? दे मोस्टली डिपेंड ऑन सी फूड्स, है ना? लेकिन वहां पे जो ऑरेंजेस होते हैं ड्यू टू क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन दैट इज लाइक वेरी बैड, मतलब एक ठीक है, हम लोग शायद कंज्यूम भी नहीं करेंगे. तो ड्यू टू ग्लोबल प्रेशर, बिकॉज जापान इज ऑल्सो अ सुपर पावर and it is also a member to WTO, World Trade Organization. तो global pressure की वजह से उसने ना नहीं कर किया और US से वहाँ पे oranges पहुँचे, import होके कहाँ पे? Japan के streets में. एक side थोड़े कम पैसे में आपको बढ़िया oranges मिल रहे हैं, दूसरे side थोड़े expensive as compared to this one, बेकार quality के oranges मिल रहे हैं. Which one would you purchase? The best quality? But Japanese did not do so. They purchased their own country's product. The US ke, you can say merchants, they conducted a survey there and found out why, they questioned people, why did not you consume this good product at a, you can say lesser price than your product? They said, this is our farm product. If we do not consume this, who in the world will? And my farmers will be dying. Understanding? ये patriotism है, ये कभी बदलता नहीं है. जो feeling है, emotion है, attributes है, social constraint है, ये कभी भी change होते नहीं है. And that is why a company which is not understanding the socio-cultural environment of a country will not be successful at all. मैंने दो example दिया. Yes or no? जापान वॉज सो कल्चरली क्लोज, अब तो धीरे धीरे कोई कुछ थोड़ा थोड़ा ओपन हो रहा है, अदरवाइज इट वॉज वेरी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड कंट्री फॉर आउटसाइडर, नॉट ओनली द यूएस, बट दे वॉन्टेड नॉट टू मिक्स अप, जो कहते हैं ना कल्चरल एक्सचेंज, है ना, वो नहीं करना चाहते थे एंड दे वर वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट अबाउट इट. टेक्नोलॉजिकल एनवायरमेंट, टेक्नोलॉजी, दो कंट्रीज को कंपेयर करो, भूटान और जापान. जियोग्राफिक टाइप में दोनों सिमिलर हैं, लेकिन एक कंट्री दुनिया का पुअरेस्ट कंट्री भूटान, दूसरा कंट्री वन ऑफ द रिचेस्ट कंट्री, यस और नो? सुपर पावर जिसको कहते हैं, इतना ज्यादा टेक्नोलॉजिकल एडवांसमेंट जापान. तो भूटान पुअरेस्ट क्यों है? बिकॉज दे यूज वेरी लिमिटेड अमाउंट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. And to be actually specific, they are the only country in the world which is having CO2 negative in their environment. It's very pure and hygienic there. Right? Bhutan. Kyunki wahan pe zyada industries nahi. Right? Ab industries nahi hai, to wo HDI calculate nahi karte, Human Development Index. Hai na? Wo HPI. Right? Calculate karte ho. Actually, World Happiness Index. They work upon world happiness. Understanding? तो ये है क्या? Technological advancement and technological application at a lowest rate. If you use the technology, जैसे हम Chinese product को consider करते हैं ना, China का है, नहीं कुछ guarantee है, ये kind of approach है हमारा, attitude है, वैसे ही हमारे product का international market में भी approach है. Why we are called as a third world country? Because of lesser amount of applicability of technology. Yes or no? Because we cannot produce to the same level as the other countries are doing. It is not that we are not capable. It is that we do not have that much amount of technology. That updated technology we are lacking in. So technology. फिर उसके बाद लीगल एंड पॉलिटिकल एनवायरनमेंट. एक कंट्री का लीगल एनवायरनमेंट और पॉलिटिकल एनवायरनमेंट, लेट्स से 1991 से पहले इंडिया का जो सिनेरियो था, वाज एनीथिंग पॉसिबल फॉर आउटसाइड बिजनेसमैन टू कम एंड डू बिजनेस इन इंडिया? it was closed. It was restricted. And then we had FERA, Foreign Exchange Regulation Act. You should know about these things. Foreign Exchange
Regulation Act.
And which one is now in working? Foreign Exchange Management Act, 1999. Right? Foreign Exchange
Management Act.
Earlier we were restricting the foreign capital to come to India. Foreign businesses to come to India. Or kyun na kare? 250 saalo tak British East India Company ne hukumat ki. Right? 1991 ke baad scenarios change. We opened up our market for global businesses and we now today promoting that they should come. Like Make in India like campaign we have today. Right? You should come and do business here with us. Do produce by exploiting our resources, human, capital, natural, whatever we have. Exploit these all resources and work and produce so that we can increase what? Export. Yes or no? Kya increase kar sakte hain?
Export.
So that will be correcting our balance of payment. Hai na? You know what is balance of payment? Like we have a trading account, profit and loss account. एक साइड हम ट्रांजेक्शन रिकॉर्ड करते हैं एक्सपेंसेस के, एक साइड इनकम की. तो वैसे ही इंडिया का भी एक अकाउंट है विच इज कॉल्ड बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट. एक तरफ हम एक्सपोर्ट रिकॉर्ड करते हैं, एक तरफ इंपोर्ट रिकॉर्ड करते हैं. मतलब एक तरफ रिसीट्स, दूसरी तरफ पेमेंट. एंड इट नीड टू एक्चुअली बैलेंस. है ना? बोलते हैं ना हम डेफिसिट में है कंट्री. कैसे पता चलता है? बाय दिस अकाउंट. और राइट, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड योर लीगल एनवायरमेंट. तब रेस्ट्रिक्शन था, अब ओपन अप है. अभी भी बहुत सारी जगहों पे रेस्ट्रिक्शन है. राइट, पॉलिटिकल एनवायरनमेंट. एक कंट्री का पॉलिटिकल सिनेरियो बुरी तरह से अफेक्ट करता है बिजनेस को. कैसे? इज इट पॉसिबल फॉर यू टू डू बिजनेस इन अफगानिस्तान राइट नाउ? कंट्री इज नॉट स्टेबल बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट स्टेबल. कैन यू डू बिजनेस लेट्स से इन सीरिया राइट नाउ? Why I am referring these countries? Because ऐसा situation ना अपने country में तब था जब emergency आया 1973-75. है ना? क्या हुआ था? Country was actually not having any proper government. It was managed by the presidents. है ना? The president managed कर रहे थे. उस time पे किसी business को India में आना चाहिए क्या? नहीं चाहिए. And why these all businessmen? अच्छा देखो, महाराष्ट्र में मुंबई इज नोन एज क्या? विच कैपिटल? इकोनॉमिक फाइनेंशियल कैपिटल ऑफ द कंट्री. बट इट इज नो मोर नाउ. व्हाई? ड्यू टू टैक्सेस, ड्यू टू अदर फैक्टर्स. राइट, कंपनीज आर फ्लीइंग फ्रॉम हियर टू लेट्स से गुजरात टू अदर पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. राइट, ड्यू टू सम political and legal constraint. Right? Then aata hai global environment. Anything which is happening, let it be economic, let it be social, let it be technological, legal or political, pure world mein uska impact aapke business pe hoga. And after pandemic, this particular, you can have to mention what health measures. Yes or no?
Yes.
Guys, this is your business environment and this is the factor. Everything, every single parameter of this particular factor or every single force does have a remarkable effect on your decision making as a businessman. Did you like the concept?
Yes.
Samajh mein aaya na?
Yes.
Sure. We'll wind up.